This week on The Wire, home offices now a priority, interest rates to stay low for 2 years, and home loans increase as restrictions ease. G'day guys, my name's Tim Guest and welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate. We can get all the top stories happening this week in finance, real estate, investment, and more. Now please like, comment, and share this video. And if it's your first time tuning in, don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. Let's kick it off with our top story for the week. Home offices now a priority. So a home office has become more important to homeowners since the onset of COVID-19, shows new research from the Real Estate Buyers Agents Association. Now the study reveals the top five priorities are now at number one, the kitchen, two, outdoor entertaining areas, three, home office, four, multiple living areas, and five, the bedrooms. Now this marks quite a sharp change in behavior, as 2 years ago, the home office did not even make the top 10, and that comes from REBAA President Kate Backos. Now, buyers are looking for a quiet space to work from home, specifically a space away from the family living area, whether this be a separate office or an extra bedroom that can accommodate this, she says. No longer is a study nook or a small allocated space for a desk a suitable alternative for a professional and or creative worker. Now, we are now seeing a heightened demand for second study spaces, more generously proportioned co-working spaces in the home, and a sharp focus on internet connectivity. Guys, now for our next story. Interest rates to stay low for 2 years. So borrowers can expect low interest rates for another 2 years following the Reserve Bank's decision to leave the cash rate at 0.25%. And that comes from financial advisor Alex Jamieson from AJ Financial Planning. Property investors can breathe a sigh of relief with interest rates expected to remain low for at least the next 2 years, he says. With the Australian government bond paying only 0.26% on a two-year term, this provides us with some indication of where the markets think interest rates are headed, which is essentially nowhere. The market is pricing in no material hikes for the next 2 years. Now, AMP Capital economist Shane Oliver doesn't expect a change in interest rates anytime soon either. He says the RBA could drop the cash rate to 0.1%, but they don't want to go negative rates, he says. Even if they did, it would only have a small impact on mortgage rates. Now, the RBA says the economic downturn is not as severe as earlier expected, and a recovery is now underway in most of Australia. Now, moving on to our final story of the week, home loans increase as restrictions ease. So in June, new home loans rose 6.2% compared to May, with the housing finance sector adding over $17 billion in value. And that comes from the latest figures from the Australian Bureau of Statistics. One company to confirm the uplift is mortgage aggregator Finsure Group, which settled $15.6 billion in loans during the 2020 financial year. That's reflecting a year-on-year increase of 23% despite difficult market conditions. The recent improvements are attributed to COVID-19 restrictions being lifted in most parts of Australia and the announcement of the Home Builder Scheme. ABS Chief Economist Bruce Hockman says the rise in housing loan commitments in June reflects the easing of COVID-19 restrictions in May on auctions, open houses and mobility in general. Rate City Research Director Sally Tindall agrees. It's not surprising to see new lending has bounced back in June as restrictions began to lift on auctions and open homes in May, she says. According to the ABS, new owner-occupier loans rose 5.5%, while investor loan commitments increased 8.1% over the month. Owner-occupier loans through first home buyer loan schemes rose 3% over the period as well. Well, guys, they're the top stories for this week. Now, please don't forget to like, comment, and share this video, and follow or subscribe wherever you are seeing this. Have a great week, and remember, there's only one thing in life that makes a difference. That's action. Thanks a lot, guys. Bye for now.